Hey everybody, Cardboard Jesus with you, welcome. Random Divisions, three boxes, Allen and Ginter, plus a non-sports spot. So seven divisions total, but come this way. Okay, let's roll some dice. Eleven is going to be our roll for random divisions, and dude, Google Chrome dragging ass on me. Come on, man. I got time for this? Ain't nobody got time for this. I'm still very embarrassed about the cash me outside business. This? All right, whatever. But I was that far behind. Cash me outside. Some white trash girl who was on Dr. Phil. I didn't know anything. I didn't know who it was, and then everybody was laughing at me about it. In the office, too. It even, like, went around. Like, Julie knew today when she came in that I didn't know anything about it. The video that she has is terrible. Hang on. 11 times. All right. That's what that looks like. Wait, she's seriously like 13? All right, this is what we look like. Hang on a second. Oh, you know you love the Ginter. Dude, I will agree. She looks way older than 13. Like insanely older than 13. All right. NL West. Coleman is what you got. Well, who knows? Slide a thing over and let's see. Could be magical. I probably should have emptied the trash, but we'll see what we can do. There's an oversized box loader card. I'm gonna do them last. Alright, I'll be frank about this. I don't know a whole lot about the variations and whatnot, so I'm gonna go through them. Showing it things that I think look fancy. Everything's gonna ship. You know, I'm not gonna steal Ginter from you. little tricky. Yeah, I mean, that's the thing. I'm shipping all of it. But, I mean, at the same time, like, if there's something that is nice, I would like to get it. So there are SPs on the minis. I mean, do you know? Can you tell me right quick what it looks like? Is it like a border or like the different back? Because I've heard it all. I've heard many different things. Blank back. A&G black color borders. Now see, now we all out of control. Now we just out of control. Rizzo, I honestly do not know. Gary was the one that was like opening most of it. I'm gonna take a wild guess and say that yes, it probably has, because I can't imagine that he would have left three loose boxes if no rip card had come out. No, yeah, that's the only thing. I don't know for sure, but that's my guess. All right. Let's just get through some of this. All right. Looking for weird backs on minis. Dude, I love these. I mean, gravitational waves. Gravitational waves. It's terribly interesting, this stuff. Cliffs of Mohair. I mean, faux reels. Okay, so let's just as a question. Like, this is an Allen and Ginter background, right? Does this make it shorter printed than, say, the Salza and Junior, like the Steven Salza? So that makes it SP. All right, so we're going to go ahead and throw that in a sleeve. All right, first hit appears to be coming up. New York Yankees. Framed mini auto, Rob Reschneider. I like the weird frame ones. Yes, it is 324. Okay, I'm just going to. This, I got to tell you, is one of my personal friends, Matt Stoney, as I have met him, and we are, like I said, close personal friends. The only celebrity that I have ever, like, stopped and asked if I could have a picture with. Who the F is this dude? Lawrence Levy superfan? Huda what? It's Marlon. Who? Huda what and huh? Hit him with the nose. Yeah, I didn't know the Marlins had super fans, frankly. Lorenzo Cain. I mean, it's got the Allen and Ginter thing. It's only 111, but it's got the Allen and Ginter thing. Let's leave it. Just leave it either way. Just keep the on the end case. On the end case. More Marlins. Jose Fernandez. Swatchery. Not gonna be a whole lot many more of those. Let's pray to Jesus that Cepeda is not, and he's not. That's not either. Is that plates and patches going to be anything decent? Strongest man in all of baseball, Giancarlo Stanton. Kay Dacey, have you ever wondered who 1 through 8 are, or 1 through 7, really? Because, no, like, I mean, you're Kay Dacey 8. So who is straight Kay Dacey at Yahoo? Who is then Kay Dacey 1, Kay Dacey 2, Kay Dacey 3, Kay Dacey 4? Or was 8 your choice? Noice! That's baller. That is baller style. I love it. I know. I knew you were kidding, but still. I mean, it's like when I signed up for like some stuff, like they kicked me out to a number. I was like, I ain't want no number. The only number going to be on mine is 69. Ginter is not the easiest to get out, but no, Rizzo, I don't even think it was like that, honestly. I mean, I think Gary was like doing them as like wars and stuff. I'm almost certain that it wasn't like a case that somebody started going through, hit, and then left. Because, I mean, dude, if that was the case, I would never have even allowed it to have been open. Like, if I knew that it was a dead case, it's not my job for you to get shit. You know, it is my job to do everything I can in my power to get you good stuff. Well, no, I mean, it's a real concern, Rizzo. It's a real concern that, you know, that kind of stuff does happen. And I mean, listen, it's still very well, you know, may not be great, but if I had known that, like, that the rip, that everything good was out of it, I'd tell you that it was, and then if you wanted to make your decision after that, you make your decision with whatever knowledge I can give you. Because that's always, like, weirded me out with, like, other breakers that, like, go through product and, like, will take, like, the good stuff out if they can and then give, you know, customers garbage. 70% of the customers that I have are only here because I hit them something. You know? Mom is doing well. Hopefully getting her down here in like the next little bit, but I got to see her a couple weeks ago, and it was very nice to see her. It felt good, and I've been talking to her more, like just making an effort to call her every few days to see what's up. Weber with the AG background, number 316. Thank you for asking. Well, Andrew, that is very kind of you. I mean, hopefully one day I can do something better than the Eli and, you know, add you to the list of people to hang around because I've hit you something massive. All right. How about a Dellen Betances? That's not inspiring amazingness, I'll be honest with you. Storin, AG background. Yeah, the next Vlad out of whatever, I mean, I don't know, has it been pulled out of Chrome yet? If it hasn't been pulled out of Chrome yet, we can try and work on getting that. Okay, this, one of those weirdos, Paul Macbeth. Disc golf champion. Why I both love Allen and Ginter and why it is perplexing. Because it's weird stuff that's kind of cool sometimes, but I don't know that anybody wants it to, like, buy it. Jason Sklar. The Penny Auto, I'd have to look. Because, yeah, I wanted that myself. Kind of. I mean, I... Again, the wife has cut me off, so, I mean, I got no buying anything, but... With the opportunity, I definitely would have gone after that Penny. I need a Nick Anderson. Is really what I need. I got a Scott Skiles. I need a Nick Anderson. If he even has autos. I honestly do not even know if he does or not. Don't be jumping out at me. Hey! Rip card. Rib card is still here. 49 out of 50. Josh Donaldson. I've never seen one before. Oddly enough, I've never seen one. I'm going to get through the rest of this. Decision can be made later. I mean, if Josh Donaldson to 50, it doesn't. All right, so, I mean, I guess we have learned something. Jumbo cards, dude. Just jumbo cards.
rip it.
What if it's a miniature Josh Donaldson to 50 to 99 inside of it? You haven't lost a whole lot. I see it right there. You can just, if you dare, rip this card open to discover a collectible exclusive mini card embedded inside. All right, the Betances jersey. I'm going to Rizzo. I'll set that out the way, off to the side. I mean, wouldn't that be? Oh, I mean, if he was the strongest man in all of baseball. What, Airhead, the rip card? Dude, I mean, why not? I mean, we're... It's interesting. I mean, like, literally inside of this... There's another card. Maybe it's better. Maybe it's not. The only way that you can find out is to destroy the one card. I mean, you tear the back of it open, so I mean, it's not like you don't have to burn it or anything, but it's still... I've never ripped one. Rizzo, I don't know, man. I don't know. Yeah, exactly. Your head. No bleeders. Did you follow up to find out, like, what it was if they did rip it? I mean, like, if it was, you know, if it was, like, a Bryant or something, you know, then you got some questions. I mean, honestly, the Josh Donaldson, if you do rip it, it's not, you know, it's not crushing. But, I mean, again, you never know. And it even says, it's inside the car will be an exclusive mini parallel, an exclusive mini wood parallel, an exclusive mini metal parallel, a red mini auto, or a one-of-a-kind sketch card. Wow. All right, another weird Michelle Steele. Another weird one. Who knows? I mean, this is this decisions to be made. Decisions to be made. That is a panty relic. Timothy Busfield. Memorabilias. Come on, man. The last one's got to be an autograph. Don't even crap on me with. She does work for ESPN. Yes. Timothy Busfeld does not work for ESPN. That I'm aware of. Did you guys hear that the Mike Jasperson, like the guy, the owner of Jaspy's Hobbyland, like he's getting his own Ginter card next year? Like he won it at that Topps Chris Bryant party thing? Grandal with the AG background. No, dude. I mean, it's pretty cool. I mean, because he worked for Topps like for 20-something years or something like that. Andrew Miller, AG background. That's what I'm... I already talked to his son. I asked his son, like, hey, how much do you think... Mike going to charge me, you know, for autographs on this stuff because I'm going to straight up sell it. But I like him. He's a good dude. Like, I have zero bad things to say about either of the Jaspersons. And I can come up with some stuff, but they're genuinely good people. Okay. It's another framed one. It is an eBay 101. I can tell that right now. It says 1 out of 25. eBay 101, 1 out of 25. Seriously? Seriously? Another Ref Schneider. Another Ref Schneider. I don't know if it makes any difference, but it's I mean, it's more that we just hit. The frame ones are good looking cards. They are good looking cards. Okay. That's what we got. Hang on this one. Let me mark this down right now. So Kate Acey, Ripper Ship is the question that I have. Oh, I gotta do the big ones too. Never mind. Let me do those first. Let me put some of these in a box. Put them in a box. Put them in a box. No, the Betances, I heard and already took off to the side and put his name on, so. That we are clear with. All right, let's do these. Well, hang on. Let me put these up first. Let's get them. Is everything up that needs to be up, up? You know, things don't need to get like need to get uppity with the up, up. So, what's in here? Mets David Wright. I don't even know what you're talking. I mean, what is a bleeder? Because now I feel like I'm just confusing something. Mariners. Oh, dude, no, dude, I'm tiny. Yeah, I ain't gonna bust nobody up like that. I only go with experienced ladies, so you know, that's how I do. Ooh, it's very exciting. It's very exciting. All right, Josh Donaldson. I've never destroyed a card before. I've never purposely messed up a card. I feel weird about it. I feel very weird about it. Oh, this is... All right, Kate Acey. I'll just throw them in a pile with the other ones. Oh... That hurt. It was painful. All right, it's interesting. It is interesting. It is a mini hand numbered autograph, 5 out of 10. For Cord McCoy, Rodeo Champion, 5 out of 10. Cord McCoy. I didn't expect it either. He was on Amazing Race. That's right. That's right. My wife is a race fan. All right, so let's get you in here. I don't want you getting all messed up. That's surprising. All right, this one I'll put back together as best I can. Josh Donaldson. I haven't watched it in a while. I mean, it's been a couple of years even since I like sat down and watched it. Probably the Globetrotters. Maybe the last one. And I mean, it's pretty cool. That's what's like very weird and strange and all about all of this. No more DVRs. 21 in the mixer. That's it. All right. Let me. Print this out right quick. Yeah, that's the only way that I watch TV. It is literally the only way that I watch. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Is the only way that I watch stuff is on DVR. $3.50? Damn, man, mine's like $120, and I'm looking to drop a hammer on it. And that's internet and stuff too.